overall, I'm sure it was a sad day, but this want to talk about Saturday for Lance.
Well, you know what? It was it was a sad day, but it was also a day of mixed emotions. I want to thank Shane, Lance's son, and his other son Rusty. They and the entire Russell family made sure that it wasn't something that Lance would not have wanted. It was a remembrance, a service that was basically, and they tried their best not to have it sad. They didn't have, you know, they didn't have a preacher or pastor on hand to do a big eulogy that would bring everybody down. They had the entire room filled. It was Lance's urn was there, and they had the entire room filled with Lance Russell memorabilia, pictures, photographs, plaques, awards, all of this sort of stuff that he had done throughout his entire life, and especially his throughout his wrestling career. And so it was just like 2 hours at the funeral home where people just walked around and looked at all of this stuff, and everybody that was there, of course, was either a friend of the family or a fan of Lance Russell. So everybody was just sharing, you know, Lance stories and what they remembered about Lance. And so it wasn't sad at all. Then at the end, Shane had asked me and Dave Brown to speak just for a few minutes, and I got up first and you know, just basically told everybody how much Lance meant to me, you know, and I think I said this last week on the podcast, but Lance to me was like the old movie, It's a Wonderful Life. You know, he did have a wonderful life, but I don't know if Lance ever realized how many people and how important his life was to other people around him and how he touched other people's lives. And then in my case, I just reminded everybody that without Lance Russell, I would have never been a wrestler. I would have never been in this business in any way, shape, form, or fashion. So everything that I've done throughout my life, connected with wrestling and the career that I've had, as great as it's been, Lance Russell was that one person that in the very beginning was responsible for that. And then and Dave Brown, who was Lance's partner and the top reigning meteorologist in the city of Memphis for 20 or almost 30 years, I guess, or maybe more than that. But anyway, Dave Brown was, he got up and told everybody how he owed all of his success and his career and the things in his life to the fact that Lance Russell got him started in the business too. And he went on to mention so many other names and people that Lance had a hand in starting when Lance was the boss and the program director at Channel 13 TV station. And so it was nice. It was not one of those tear jerking kind of things, which I know that's what I said. Lance would not want everybody to be standing around crying and grieving and mourning and everything. He would want to be remembered, of course, but in a fond way. And I think that's what we all did. And then Shane had come to me earlier and said, hey, when we get through with the service at the funeral home, can we all come down to your club and everybody raise a glass and toast Lance's life? And so that's what we did. We all went down to the club at 3 o'clock, spent about 3 hours down there, and everybody just had a great time. Once again, we had three TVs going with all, you know, Lance Russell, his most classic moments from Memphis wrestling were playing on all of those screens, and people were just reminiscing and having a great time. And Shane bought at the end, Shane bought shots for everybody in the place, you know, in remembrance of Lance. And it was a great day. Then afterwards, Lauren and I went to dinner that night with Shane and Lance's entire family. So it was a day of mixed emotions. You know, everybody loved Lance Russell and nobody more than me, but, he did. We all just kept reminding each other that, hey, 91 years, Lance lived 91 great years. And it was a wonderful life for Lance.